That's terrible now. There you go. Toggle that little switch.
Yeah, I just didn't want to fucking sit so close to the microphone, but I think this thing's a piece of shit.
Can I be heard?
You are heard. No. And once again, you sound like you're on a telephone.
All right. Well, I can do this or switch over to my phone.
No,
I finally got the fucking computer running great.
Stay with this. It's fine. I mean, it doesn't sound bad. Have you listened back to it to hear it?
Nah.
I don't know if I've actually completed a whole show wearing it.
It'll be fine.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Fuck.
Man, it's cold as fuck in this house, man. It's like fucking 62 degrees, maybe. Dogs are all... I'm not turning on my heat, man. It's fucking not even November yet. That shit ain't coming on until November. I'm just gonna put on a blanket. Kick back. Smoke some bong hits.
Put on a sweatshirt.
Nah, I don't wear no clothes around here.
Eggs.
God damn, dude. I sit around naked, bud.
Right.
Ew.
That's just the most disgusting thing I can fucking think of.
Wow. I just imagine a leather chair that smells like dogs in your fucking office, even though you don't let dogs in your office.
I don't fucking sit in my chair naked, but I will sit in it just fucking in my underwear all the time.
I will say, if you did fucking naked, your fucking balls would just stick to the leather.
It's fine. Like, I don't care. Like,
you get up, it'd be like... You know,
when I sleep in hotel rooms with these guys, I sleep naked. I don't give a fuck.
Good luck with that. Good luck with that.
Nah. Well, yeah, we did book them fucking rooms. That's a good deal. Fucking, it'll be fun.
Have a good time.
You know what they're gonna be? I'm assuming the one's gonna be at the regular Dairy Con rate, and then the other one will probably be.
It's $542 total.
Oh, that's not bad.
No, I'm just gonna throw it on my card, and you guys can just treat me to pizzas and fucking tables.
Deal.
Now I'm gonna also get DA to give you a hand job.
Oh, that'll work. Nah, if you come, man, you're like, you can stay in the room for free. Like,
yeah, so. Gotta travel.
Uh oh, he heard the magic word.
I better get the other room.
Well, with the way we got it set up, we got four fucking beds now.
Yeah.
So I mean, you can just rock that couch again.
Yeah.
Fucking dirt couch.
Gross.
We'll just leave dirt at home.
I hope it's not the same room where dirt slept.
Nah. He slept next to my bed in the corner.
That's right.
That shit was hilarious.
I had a big bed.
Remember when we had to move him from the fucking couch bed to when he was passed out?
You gotta get the fuck out my bed, boy. I was gonna beat his ass.
I think we literally picked him up and laid him on the fucking cushion.
On the ground.
We picked him up out of the bed and sat him on the ground. No one was going to sleep at that point either.
But I tell you what, man, I've been in less comfortable positions at a fucking convention, and that's just some shit you got to deal with sometimes. Mm. You know what I mean? Who hasn't had to sleep on the floor at a fucking convention?
Not Chris.
Yeah, I never.
No,
slept on
not
the floor.
Chris. Not
he won't move. I think rooming is with guys is half the fun.
Yeah, I think it is too, man. It's a good time to just, you know, really have that brotherhood and that fellowship.
The only thing that sucks is when people start shitting.
Yeah. That's the fucking funny shit, though.
I didn't really experience too much of it at DairyCon, because I think that after TFCon, I was like, literally, no more shitting in the go in the bathroom. Right there.
I don't think anybody pooped, like, the whole time, because all we ate was fucking curds.
Oh, I pooped.
Yeah, man, that blood I had in fucking TFCon woke y'all up. That shit was fucking great, dude.
I probably dropped a log on the airplane that was so hard. Probably dropped out of the sky and killed somebody.
Oh, fuck, man. All right, so we don't have a guest, huh?
Our guest is manic depression.
Somebody text Welty and tell him to get on here.
We should. No, you should. We should have fucking Tyler.
I'm gonna text him right now.
Yeah.
Do we need Welty's energy?
No. Well, I mean, you like talking about that Hasbro stuff.
That's true.
This shit looks pretty flame.
He gets pretty excited about it.
So,
we gotta have somebody that gets excited about this shit that we're gonna be talking about because it's all junk to me.
That's Bug's job.
About it.
So, cool. That Tetra Jet shit.
Bugs is too busy putting dicks in his mouth.
Mm.
Yeah, he is. But now he got that fucking shit done quick today, and he got the fucking room booked like that, man. So.
Yeah, well, hopefully he won't. He'll have to get his own room because he's banging that chick.
Fucking DA just procrastinated and shit.
No, I would have done it. What did you say the total was? 520 something or 540 something?
542 with tax and probably fees. So probably right around 600, I imagine.
What if Bugs gets with this chick and she's like overbearing and he fucking listens to her?
It's exactly what's going to fucking happen, dude.
No, I'm like, you can't go to Dairy Con. You ain't going no toy show, little baby boy.
What about she has a penis?
Well, here's the deal, man. We're on the verge of losing him. Like, he's going to get a girlfriend. It's going to be his first piece of ass, and he's going to be all up in that shit.
He's going to go off to college and
he's
going to
fucking, he's going to have her kids move in with him. And
she ain't got no kids.
She don't?
No, this one don't have no kids. She's younger. She ain't got no kids.
Yeah, she's like 22, isn't she?
Fair enough.
No, he's gonna...
I knew she was married, so I just assumed that they popped one out of her big ass.
No, man.
No, believe it or not, sometimes young kids do fucking marry for fucking stupid love.
How the fuck did she get so big?
Man, you know I love me a big ass bitch.
Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
And look,
hell yeah.
Let's be straight. Some girl's got to fucking be able to handle Bugs.
Mm, that too. You can't just have some fucking little
that's
bitch.
That's a good fucking point.
You got to have a girl with some
but
tits.
Man, sometimes, man, I see these big fucking redneck fucking boys the size of Bugs with little fucking tiny fucking wives and girlfriends. And
that's
just
true.
Like,
I don't
understand it, but it happens a lot, you know?
No, I guess they just sit on top all the time.
Fuck yeah, boy. I ain't going boy. To work neither. That's how I got sat.
Ride this painter.
God, you gotta, get on there, gotta, girl.
Even if Bugs has a small, he's probably still packing compared to me.
Yeah, I just like it when the titties are bouncing in my face, dude. You know what I mean? So I don't fucking like being on top. Just fucking get it. Just get the work done so I can go to sleep.
Well,
shit.
I back, bud.
You know what I mean? Rub my back afterwards. Crack
while
that shit.
Sleeping. Rub my back while I sleep, baby.
Bring it over.
I like it when you rub my back. It puts me to sleep. You know what I mean? You just pass out.
Bring over that good crack.
Mm-hmm.
I splurged on the captain tonight instead of
that. Attaboy.
Yeah, I don't have captain. I got fucking Sailor Jerry or whatever the fuck. Private.
I'm thinking
Todd.
About fucking
I always get that Admiral Nelson.
I think that's what I got. I don't know. I got fucking sub. I got fucking Commander Shitfaced.
You're drinking?
Commander Shitfaced. Yeah, I'm out of vodka, dude. I didn't have enough vodka to make a drink, so I didn't even take out the bottle.
Are you one of those? Well, I actually had to run and go get liquor because I only had enough to get drunk and not continue to get drunk.
I didn't feel like making the wife go get it. That's normally what I do.
Loretta!
Penis.
I need some vodka, goddammit. I'm sober as fuck. What sucks is, though, the only thing I'll drink rum with is, like, Coke. And so, like, I don't really like drinking soda. So, like, I got fucking Coke.
I hit it with that diet now, bud.
Oh, well, I got that. I like Coke Zero. That's my shit.
Oh, I should do that, dude.
Yeah, Coke Zero is about the only thing with no calories in it that I can drink. Except for water.
Now, the Coke Zero also has zero caffeine, too, right?
Mm-mm.
No?
It's caffeine.
Caffeinated.
Well, you remember Pepsi Max, like the extra caffeinated fucking Diet Pepsi from back in the day?
Just clear Pepsi.
No, man, it tasted...
In Max Headroom.
All right, Pepsi Max was basically their version of Coke Zero. It was Pepsi with, like, whatever the fuck they use in the Coke Zero. And extra caffeine.
It was fucking rat poison.
Yeah.
Rat poison. You can get high for rat poison, can't you?
Your mic's cutting out, JL.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah.
Can you still hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. No. But if you were like moving back and forth, your mic, your switch maybe got loose.
I ain't fucking moving. What you talking about?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Didn't want to asperge your there with your lethargy.
I don't even know if my microphone actually even works.
Yeah, I don't know. My I feel like my shit's been acting up.
Just a couple of your laptop just picking up your fucking voice. Not your mic. What?
Does it get louder when I get closer?
Yep.
Ah, fucking Jesus.
Sure does. It does. It doesn't really get louder, just distorted.
You get dumber.
Yeah, well, that's not fucking...
Well, I'm gonna.
Not easy to do.
I'm going to step out on my porch. My only 4 feet from.
Am I still coming in clear?
Yep. You know, this fucking Triptychon would be good for a microphone stand. You could just hold it because nobody will buy the fucking thing from me, so.
That Triptychon's fire, though. Why would you sell that?
I've been trying to sell it, and nobody wants it, so I'm going to keep it.
Are you talking about... Which one are you talking about? Are you talking about the Titans one, or are you talking about the Make Toys?
The Planet X one.
Oh, yeah.
That one's fire, though.
I love that fucking Titans Returns one, man. That shit's like a blowed-up fucking G1 toy.
This one looks exactly like the video game.
Mm-hmm. Hey, JC, did that fucking... that hit you up on a couple of those things and buy one of... Wasn't he interested in one of those? The guy that was on?
Yeah, but then he fucking backed out.
It sucked that we had such interference with him. He was actually a pretty interesting
guy. Yeah, he was.
Absolutely.
And then he's like, fuck you get no money, bitch.
Anybody probe that new fucking group with, like, Gary Chalk and all them for a fucking guest?
We should. Let's see if we can get Gary Chalk on, dude.
Dude, I would love to talk to him about his fucking political views.
Yeah. His liberal gender.
Ask him why he's so delusional. Hanny won't do podcasts, bro. Everybody's been trying for years.
Let's bring him in on 100. Like, we're fucking going out. We're quitting.
Yeah.
Do us a solid.
He ain't going to do it.
Our views are... Yeah. I don't even know why.
Because we have nothing else to do with our lives.
I like to do it just because I get to hang out with you guys.
I like to smoke meth.
What the hell's that fucking noise?
I don't know. Somebody's microphone.
Noise? I think it's DA.
I'm outside.
No, I think it's JC.
It might be me because I'm fucking with screws and shit on this microphone. I'm just trying to get it situated.
Yeah, that would be it.
I took off the fucking.
I'm outside. This headset shouldn't pick up much. Like.
No, you're coming in clear as fuck, homie.
Yeah, you got it. Where'd you get that good headset?
I've always had it.
Man, you see this fucking... I guess I'm about to fucking start talking about the shit we're going to talk about on the show. I'll wait.
But Chris hears me funny on it, apparently.
No, you sound funny all the time.
He does sound like he's calling on a telephone, right?
You sound like you're calling me through somebody's booty hole.
It'll be all right.
Cool.
I tell you guys, I canceled the Omega Supreme fucking pre-order and got the Flames Toys fucking,
Star Saber?
Star Saber instead, yeah.
Hey, speaking of that.
Big lead, bro.
I have the other two Flames Toys, and, like, I didn't realize that the Omega is shorter than Metroplex and shit. I mean, it makes sense. He should go with
Chug figure.
Well, he's sized to go with Devastator, which I forgot about, and I was like, man, I don't know if I want to fuck another Omega this little.
But Metroplex would have been way bigger in the cartoon than Omega.
Yeah,
yeah. Anyway.
I just had it in my mind.
Kudos.
No, he looks like fun and shit, but it's not like I won't be able to get it later. I'll just buy it later.
And I think that the problem with, like, any more city bots with fan toys would be, like, size. Because, man, like a Metroplex, that'd have to be, like, a foot taller than Omega Supreme. It's just not doable.
But I really like the Flames toy stuff, and I do like that Star Saber, man, so I'll just pick that shit up.
I think Unicron will reset the scale on that, and then they'll come out with a 27-inch fucking Metroplex. It's probably a couple head taller.
I was just about to bring up the fact, do you think that this whole Unicron crowdfunding thing is happening for the simple fact is look at all the last, like, Titan figures that have all been clearanced out that didn't sell.
I don't know, man. I think it's a special project that goes beyond that, because I don't think that has anything to do with it, because look at the sale barge. You know, you got to take that into consideration.
Yeah, they only wanted to make, they only needed 5,000 for that, and they sold 8,000 of those fuckers. I think that's why they did 8,000 this time.
That's probably right. Probably has something to do with it, but I don't think it has anything to do with their other stock going to clearance. Because once they fucking sell it out to the retailers, they're probably getting a flat rate for it anyway.
I get that.
And then probably the supplier, the seller, the merchandiser or whatever, you know, is copping deals to fucking discount stores on shit that's sitting in warehouses that didn't move at larger retail.
You know,
you make it there.
This is the most intelligent conversation we're going to have tonight. We should probably save it for the show.
Too late.
Like, we have all the smart conversation, then like, all right. 3, 2, 1,
it ain't like we ain't recording this.
I'll be right back. You get JC saying he likes smoking meth earlier. That was kind of cool.
If he's going to hang, he's going to hang by his own accord.
Yeah, by his Honda Accord. He's going to kill his fucking dog. You know, he talks about how great the dogs are. He's like, oh, you got
this. He has to yell at him. We'll beat fucking all y'all. Well, right as you guys said that, Broody came up and laid her head on my lap.
Good.
Fuck. Fuck off, dog.
Smother with a pillow.
Don't get fucking silly on me tonight.
Hey, Chris. Chris, how's your dog doing?
They dressed it up in a coat, hat, scarf, and everything today.
And it was the pathetic, in a fucking tutu last week.
Yeah, and the pathetic fucking little thing just sat there.
He loves the attention.
Oh,
he's got
God.
Two little girls. He's probably the happiest dog in the world.
Oh, God. That poor dog.
Nah, they love that shit.
That's because they're dumb.
My I don't know, man.
I tear your face up and fuck the holes.
Like, I never had to worry about anything for my daughter in the neighborhood when she had her dog with her.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Right. Lila will walk around the fucking hood here with Broody. She's fucking
dead.
Yeah,
I mean, like, they love their fucking kids.
Mm-hmm.
It's crazy.
Mm-hmm. That is true. And they will fucking do it. Like, if somebody broke into my house right now and I wasn't home, Broody would probably be like, hey, what's up, guys? And help him carry out the fucking PlayStation. Don't forget the fucking remotes.
You forgot the cords, dumbass.
Yeah, she'd sit and fucking wiggle her butt and fucking get all happy and shit. But if somebody came in here and started fucking acting like an asshole, I guarantee she'd fucking jump, especially if someone was fucking with Mama. She's glued to her fucking head.
Mm. All right, good night, folks.
Yeah, that was a good show, guys. Fuck, we might as well start without that fucking guy.
Okay.
A brooder is like having an SUV riding around in your fucking living room.
Eric. Who is Eric?
No, don't bring me your rope. Get. I'll go downstairs and lock the fucking door.
Dude, I will fucking get up and start beating dogs right now.
Do it. Live on the air.
Please.
Stupid fucker.
And if it wouldn't be too much trouble, can you set one on fire?
These motherfuckers, man. So, Peener, he wants to go outside every fucking 30 minutes to check for see if there's a rabbit in the yard.
Yep.
Oh, man.
You don't want to go fucking potty. You don't want to do nothing. He just wants to run around to the fence to make sure there's no rabbit out there. He's fucking annoying about it. He starts whining and crying and grabbing my fucking leg when he wants to go out there.
That's when you start
on the porch and stairs.
That's when you get the other dogs riled up. The other dog's all fucking excited for going outside every half an hour. And I just want to kill him.
Let's do it.
Well, if you didn't have a...
Don't be a pussy.
Dude, my wife would fucking kill me. That's death.
It's all
if
good.
I touch one of them dogs, nah.
Probably a good thing, though, you know.
Yeah, it is, Dirt. That's a good thing. Good old buddy. I'm trying to hook up with him this weekend. I need to fucking see Dirt.
Yeah, I'm still here, though.
He's fucking... Did you guys see that video on Dove and Dirt where he got bucked off a fucking horse?
No.
He got hurt for like the week. He'd been off work. He got bucked off a horse.
How the fuck did I miss that?
He got all fucked up. I don't know. My mom posted it on there.
Recently?
Yeah, just this week.
Okay, I'm going to it right now.
I must be taken off the Terry Christian mingle list.
So it's going to have to be East, right?
Yeah. Probably visitor post. I don't know. I didn't even watch the whole fucking video. I just saw him get on a horse, and I was like, nope, and turned it off. Mm. He called me this morning. He's like, man, I got bucked off a horse.
Yeah, it's going to be under, you're going to have to find under post from others. Where's that at? All this shit has changed. It updates like every other fucking day for some reason.
Good night, folks. Yeah.
Oh, here it is.
My wife's going to bring me a chicken sandwich and cheese curds.
All right, I got to.
I want cheese curds.
Where's Eric?
He's jerking off and crying.
That's definitely Terry. Scoot back on him.
Fuck our game, get it done.
Oh, he mounted it like a boss, though.
I want to see him get bucked off.
Scoot back. You told him to scoot back, and they probably do that just so it bucks him off. Man, fuck the hillbilly kid, man.
Yeah, Derp don't fuck around. Buddy.
Telling him what to do. There's like a 12-year-old kid telling him how to ride the horse.
All right, good night, folks.
Since the dawn of time, things have happened. People have talked about those things. First with cave paintings, then with language, writing, and art. In our time, we use the internet. From the depths of nerddom come four guys who talk about things too. World famous internet celebrity, Justin L. The destroyer of BotCon, Deadbugs. A man who rejects the concept of catch and release, Justin Catfish. The guy that learned how to mow grass in the prison yard, DA. And the customizing powerhouse, Mako Aspire. This is totally awesome.
Ready?
Second.
Fucking three, two, one, go!
You fucking dork.
It's your boy Catfish. I'm back tonight. I took like a week off.
Week? It's been fucking 3 weeks.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
No, it hasn't been that long.
Yeah, it has. You ain't been on in
Might
3 weeks.
Might have been two. Might have been two.
Probably why the show sucked.
That Wednesday shit was fucking me up bad.
The best shows ever.
It just. Fuck. Anyway,
fuck my dick.
You know, fuck all y'all, first and foremost. Fuck the whole fandom. Everybody was stupid all week. We'll talk about that later. Tonight, we got JL in the house.
Durr.
What'd you get? How was your week?
My week was great. I don't think I got shit. No, wait, I got two of the reissue packs of the Soundwave cassettes, the G1 ones.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Those are good to fucking stockpile if you see them.
Yeah, well, I just, the ones I got are old and raggedy as fuck, and while I'm not going to replace the ones on the shelf with it, because I prefer to have the original, like, they are kind of nice to fuck with. They're not all busted and shit. And they're worth it just to get the fucking missile launchers and guns and shit that you're always missing.
Oh, you opened them?
Yeah, I opened them.
Oh.
Yeah, they're $20 shit. They ain't expensive.
That's true, but, I mean, it's kind of cool just to have them in the package. I think it's more meaningful, I guess.
Well, then I'll buy some on clearance for $5 later.
I hope you do.
Came in packages like that.
I don't know, man.
And I got chicken nuggets. That was cool.
I'm waiting on a chicken sandwich myself.
Man, where'd you get nuggets? Chicken fried.
From fucking Freddy's, bro.
Freddy's fire.
Dude, yeah, I hope fucking Popeye's gets right, that fucking chicken sandwich back in.
And these notes are like 2 pages long. Are we already done?
Nah, we got DA up next. DA, how's it going?
Yo.
What'd you get this week?
Man, I didn't get fucking shit.
Cool.
Not a fucking thing. Well, my week's been good. Been a lot of rain, so I've been sitting around fucking twiddling my thumbs. Taking care of some shit on the side, getting ready for winter, getting prepared for snow. Got the snow blowers out, tuned up. Addressed a couple things in my truck. You know, doing big things.
That sounds pretty fucking manly.
Yeah, for the most part. I woke up today at like 9 a.m.
Yeah, I saw that. That's fucking crazy.
Like an actual human being.
Why?
Got a lot of shit done.
Nah, you got a ways to go yet. Actual human beings around 5, 6 a.m.
Nah.
Why did you
get up? I got a lot more shit done today than I normally do.
Dude.
I only slept like, I went to bed at like 4 or 5 and got up at like 8:30.
But you didn't get anything cool?
So tonight I think I'm going to try and go to bed like a normal human being.
No, you're not. Tomorrow.
But no, I didn't get anything cool.
All right, well, moving on. Chris, how's it going?
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. No.
Because I've been talking.
A little bit.
Am I far away?
You were quiet
Mike?
There for a minute ago. You're quiet, though. You're cutting in and out.
All right. I have to fucking sit up. I can't fucking lay back and relax and do this stupid fucking show. Yeah. All right.
Lazy bitch.
Get extension on your microphone.
I tried that shit, too.
No, I do. I have a fucking extension arm on it, and it's still not close enough, so fuck it. All right. Let's just hunch over like fucking life. What did I get? I took a shot and got the new KO company AOYI Mech, their OS KO of the Siege Hound, and a 1-to-1 KO of the movie Prime, Bumblebee Prime. And they are decently made. The plastic is, well, it seems like a Wei Zhang fucking thing, just under a different name. And that's it.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right. Eric's not with us. He could quite possibly be getting his dick sucked right now. We don't know.
Yeah.
Here's hoping.
But it is possible that he hooked up with this girl right now.
Cool.
So.
That he met on ChristianMingle.com.
Hopefully he'll be with us, and hopefully he can say he got some pussy this week.
All right. Fire.
Yeah, it would be fucking flames.
And fucking flames and froth.
You know what I mean? There's a little boy all grown up.
I got fish finger.
My favorite.
JC's like, what's that?
It's like sending your daughter to prom for the first time. You know what I mean? It's a proud moment.
I should have let him borrow the Camaro.
Yeah, you probably should have. Just I feel like we're co-parents in this thing.
They're going to try and get equal visitation.
What was that movie back in the day? Fucking, God.
Back to the Future?
No, it was like fucking like three dads and a baby or some shit.
That was a show.
It's called
Three Men and a Baby.
Oh, no, yeah. That was a movie. Yeah,
that's it. It's like me, you, and fucking JL with Eric.
Yeah. Our little man has grown up so fast.
All right, let's get into the fucking news. TFC still alive and kicking with, I don't know what this is.
Dildotron.
Yeah. It looks like a remold of that Prime thing they did.
I bet you Eric knows what this is.
This is just an add-on kit for that fucking thing. That's all.
It's made out of Vienna sausages.
Yeah. The hot ones.
Hold on. It's just an add-on kit, you said?
Yeah. See, look.
Oh, that's cool.
The pink stuff is what you're getting new. Shut
the fuck up, JL.
It has a stand so you can sit on it. Look.
Yeah. Ooh, God. It's ribbed for my pleasure.
Peter Silo.
Bottom, but
well, fair enough.
That's too many fucking crevices to get poop inside, though.
Yeah.
Gross.
Bitch to clean.
Mm. Put it in the dishwasher. Yeah.
You have to get like a pressure washer out, like a leaf blower, and dry it off.
Just stick your dick in the leaf blower.
Oh man, maybe like the intake end.
No, there's a fucking fan in there.
I know.
Would you not pleasure your old lady with this thing?
No,
nah.
She'd be like, nah.
I mean, I wouldn't be above if she said, hey, you know, shove that thing in there. I'd be like, all right.
Yeah, be like, man. Don't press me with a good time. Right. Yeah,
Chris would do it and then clean it off with his fucking mouth.
No,
God damn it. Now I'm going to get sick.
I'd put a rubber on it. And unlubricate it.
That'd be the wisest thing to do. Who wants to clean that?
Nobody. All right, cool. Moving on, since nobody asked me what I got this week.
What'd you get?
This is my new hat.
Yee-yee!
Pretty cool hat. It says yee-yee on it, and it fucking got a dude catching a fish on it.
The fuck is a yee-yee?
Fish is bigger than it, bud.
Is that like a bass?
It's a yell, man. You know what I mean? It's just a country boy yell.
Ain't nobody yell no yee-yee. That's what you call your fucking grandpa when you ain't got teeth and can't pronounce shit.
Oh, man, I'm trying to read what's in the background, like what he had going on in Messenger.
Probably the chat.
Can't see that shit. Damn it.
Yeah. I ain't getting no toys, though.
A girl would.
I got Borderlands 3.
Yay.
It's a great game.
I was going to rent that bitch last night, but it was all out.
Yeah, you'll have that.
Better hit the Blockbuster.
You ever just go to the library and rent shit?
Ah, dude, they do that?
Yeah, man, they have everything.
You ever rent my dick at the library?
They just have vending machines, too, so, like, you pick out what you want, and then you get a little code for it. So it's a pretty simple process. You just get a, and it's free, so.
But they're probably all junk games, scratched shit.
Nah, they keep a pretty good collection. I mean, probably not at your library, because Mason City is hood as fuck.
His library don't even have books.
Probably not. Our library is there, all fucking like dope.
The old field of real newspapers.
Yeah. Dude, my library has, like, stations, like, where you can sit on a couch and play video games.
His library just got microfiche.
It's fucking crazy. It's so expensive as fuck, probably.
Well, I think did it not... I think it's got a little coffee shop in it and shit now.
Yeah, that's pretty baller. We got one of them too. So yeah, you can just go there and fucking get games for free.
And you can look at porno and whack off on the computer.
Maybe I'll check it out.
I doubt it.
No, you could.
It's fine. Alright, next up we got some C-Cons Combiner Wars Edition. I don't know where these or what these are from, but they look cool.
Yeah, they look great. I didn't order the first one, so I'm not going to order the rest of them hoping to get it, so fuck it.
Fair enough. The great
colors are pretty cool.
Well, I mean, it looks right. That's what they look like. I like the fucking Tented Kill, that's my favorite. Look at that motherfucker.
I really think this is the best use of the Combiner Wars molds, really.
Yeah.
Yeah, and in another chat, somebody put the that this Tentakill is Moonracer. The same.
What?
Mold. Yeah.
Well, he looks wild
yeah,
as fuck.
Yeah, you're right.
They put them side by side.
Hmm.
You can tell by the legs. It's the same fucking legs.
I just think it's wild as fuck.
Little foldy, collapsey thing. Every single fucking one of them did it, man.
I'll wait for the gift set to come out.
Yeah.
I'm not buying it at all.
I think it looks great. I mean, for what it is, fuck. I mean, I don't usually give Combiner Wars too much praise, but this is about the best use of the shit I've seen. So, fair enough. Kudos, bruh.
Bruh.
Then we got Big Ass Clear Prime. That Lewin Studios, I think is what it's called.
Yeah, it's a big old knockoff prime.
It's cool. I kind of wanted that fucking Captain America version of it, but it's all sold out now.
ISIS got all that money. Fucking terrorism.
I mean, where are you really going to put a 3-foot Optimus Prime? But just having it would be cool, you know.
You put it right next to the fucking 3-foot Unicron.
You just get him a chair and just sit him right next to you.
Get him a high chair.
Pass him a fucking Rillo. Just hang out with him.
Just take him into a bong, bro.
Nah, you don't want to fucking do that to him. You want to hang out and kick it with him and be your imaginary friend.
You could wrestle him and shit.
Mm-hmm. Just fucking hang out, dude. Wherever he goes, you go.
Buckle him in the seat of your car.
Fair. I put him on a booster seat, though, to make sure everybody could see him.
Absolutely. A couple of phone books.
Pretty baller. But no, I'm not getting this. Anybody else going to pay $400 for this?
No.
Nah.
No.
It is 3 foot. 3 feet of clear plastic, everyone. Like, that's not going to fucking break somewhere. Cool. So, I think it was yesterday or the day before, the Hasbro thing came out with the new Unicron begging with new parts, I guess. One of which is a little arc.
Pretty cool.
Yeah, it does look cool as fuck.
Die-cast.
I do. I think it should be die-cast, too. And, like, a stand for just the head, I guess. So, that's cool. Unnecessary, but at least you can have the planet. Probably, I bet you can have the planet mode and the head. Just
that'd
chilling.
Be fire, dude.
Yeah.
Die-cast. Why couldn't they make this die-cast?
I'm sorry. I couldn't hear you, bud.
You seen the little die-cast Star Wars / Hot Wheels? Hot Wheels versions of...
Yeah, they could make this die-cast.
They're like $5 to $10.
I mean, it's fine.
Just make that die-cast.
We don't know if it's die-cast or not.
They could. That's what we're saying.
I don't care.
Goddamn. Calm down.
Die-cast just chips paint real fucking easy. Like, die-cast is overrated as fuck. I'm gonna say it right now.
I agree.
The only time die-cast is cool... Too fast. The only thing I like die-cast is, like, when it's in feet and it helps it stand. That's it. Like, it's not a big deal. It's overrated.
Right. I'm listening.
And you know that, like, I've heard before, too, that, like, the metal they make die-cast out of is actually cheaper than fucking plastic.
Oh, probably.
Yeah.
Just tin. So,
I'd want the arc to at least be, like, solid piece of plastic. I don't want to pick it up and, like... feel like I could like not throw it far because it's so light.
Man,
you don't want it to be waffles on the bottom.
Yeah.
There are all these metals left over in these places called Auschwitz and Bergen-Belsen, and we just didn't have noticed.
You
got hit.
I don't know who still listens, but we probably lost them.
It's fun.
I, for $600, this fucking arc better split and fucking blow up the back half and shit. I'm gonna fucking play with it.
I don't know if it will, but and then they have a little hot rod too to go with the fucking
Oh, isn't that cute?
Little baby Galvatron, and then the hand they redesigned.
That's pretty cool.
And it looks worse, I think. But
yeah, but right. You know what, man? All your fucking, like, your old-ass, like, MMC and Generation Toy hands, they're all like that, dude.
Yeah, wow. That's true.
Like, it's fine. He's yeah, but it's probably partially, like maybe not with him, but they're going to reuse these hands for something that's going to have to hold a gun and shit.
Yeah, but what? My like, dick. What are they going to make that's that big?
My dick.
Like, it's a waffle. Like, something in the hands. Are they really saving that much plastic? I mean,
probably, but somebody will make fillers for all of that shit.
Yeah, but I don't really care. I think it's really awesome they redid the hands, because the old hands I thought were kind of a weakness of it, and now they fixed that for me, you know?
Yeah, that's fair.
And I guess they're listening to people, so that's, like, cool.
So and they didn't raise the price.
There's 2 days left, so...
They're going to make it. This motherfucker's already in production. I guarantee it.
Yeah, 3 days left, actually.
They're already cranking this motherfucker out somewhere. It's been done. They're already fucking at Ollie's and shit.
Dude.
And it looks like, is the stand going to be clear? Like, I guess the stand's going to be clear, because if so, that's fucking fire, too.
That's a different stand.
Yeah, I know, but it's clear.
Yeah, I like that, too. I hope it is clear as well.
I don't know, man. I actually didn't order a second one yet, but I'm still thinking about it.
Oh, by the way, I want to point out the fact that I've heard people talking about how, like, it will not stand on its own without the stand, and that is not true. It does on its own.
Look at the size of them fucking feet. That motherfucker has the stand.
Yeah.
I mean, no goddamn, you could probably throw it, and that bitch will land on his fucking feet.
I don't feel like they're going to put out a bad product with this.
Nah.
I know a lot of people are saying that, but I don't think they are.
The people that want it to be bad are the ones that can't fucking afford it and ain't going to buy it anyways. Who gives a shit?
That's true.
If you ain't buying it, then who cares? You ain't part of the fucking discussion.
Yeah, I'll be glad when this is fucking over.
Kick rocks, nerds.
I am so tired of hearing about this stupid fucking thing.
So what? Good part is that it don't come out, even if it funds, it don't come out for a fucking year and a half. You're going to be hearing about it for a year and a half.
No, not so vociferously. You know, as soon as this fucking deadline passes, we won't have to hear about it for, you know,
no, because I'm going to post year and a half. I'm going to post every damn day that it got funded. Oh, I got funded. Fuck you, pores. I'm taking pre-orders, $1,500.
Funded plus day 37.
I said the other day, yes, like, I said this morning somewhere, man, I'm like, I hope, like, it don't go higher than 7,000, and they, like, they put out a fucking message, like, hey, we're gonna make it, but in order to cover it, we're gonna raise chug prices $5 a piece. Didn't get it fully funded, so we can make this for our real fans.
Durr. That's fucking stupid.
Fuck.
So already people bitching about, like, what the new Siege stuff they just showed. Like, oh, God, I wonder how much this is going to cost. It's going to be the same fucking price as it's been for the last 8 goddamn years. Leaders are 50, Voyagers are 30, Deluxes are 15 or 20. They're 20 now. They went up because they actually started fucking putting plastic in them.
Yeah, like ankle tilt.
Yeah, we're going to talk about these new figures in a minute. These things are fucking fire looking,
yeah,
dude.
They look
good.
Actually.
Cool. Hey, Bugs.
What's up?
She suck your dick? I really wish I hadn't yelled that loud. I mean, my children are just upstairs.
Hey, Grandma! Grandma's here. What Daddy said?
I ain't no grandma living
right
here.
Now?
What'd you say?
But the answer is no, not yet. No.
God damn it!
Come on, man, get it.
What are you doing?
Don't talk about his fucking.
You hush.
This is important.
You hush.
What if he tells her about the show and then she listens?
She's like, not gonna listen.
No.
If I get married, she's still not gonna fucking
listen. It's best if you keep this show a secret from your family and friends.
Yeah.
But it's fine. Did you get anything this week, sir? And how are you doing?
Let's see. I did get Fans Toys Breakdown.
Oh, damn. I did finally open mine up, too.
Fans on fire, bud.
So I haven't transformed him yet, but all the pictures make him look thinner than what he really is. I'm perfectly fine with it. And I got the reissue Motormaster coming. That's the only reason I jumped in on getting the Fans Toys Breakdown. So I'll be getting the whole set. But
yeah.
God damn it. I'm still thinking about it, man. I got to ask the wife tonight because she fucking told me no yesterday.
But
you don't have to ask her. You tell her what it is.
Nah. Yeah.
That makes me laugh when people say that.
You laugh all you want, man. My stomach's going to be full as a motherfucker tonight.
She going to pump you full of sperm or something?
Nah, dude, but I'm getting a chicken sandwich and some cheese curds. So.
Want some cheese curds.
Yeah, everybody does, man. I get
the fucking fries from Freddy's with the fry sauce.
Yeah, that's fucking horrible. I hate the fries man. You're
fucking stupid.
I don't really care for fries.
You know what, man? You can fuck off with them little tiny fucking ghetto fries. Like, I'm not eating that shit.
Yeah, I'm not
cut with salt, but they are shoestring. They're thin.
No,
I like that, man. You know what's gross is fucking steak fries. Nasty.
Hold on, Eric, back me up, bro.
I agree with you. While I love the Freddy sauce, I was not a fan of the shoestring French fries. I prefer them much bigger.
Did you try their white
cheddar
cheese curds?
That's what she said. Hey.
No, I only had the burger and the fries with the sauce.
Oh my fucking god, they're cheese curds, bro. Lord Jesus.
Are they made out of dick cheese?
Man, they're made out of fucking like white cheddar, like a white cheddar mix. Nice. And they got that good fucking like Wisconsin style batter. You know, not too breaded, not breaded, but just the batter. It's fucking money, man. So yeah. And that shit's coming to me like at 8:30.
What's taking so long, man?
My old lady's working.
So get the fuck off of work and go get them food.
It doesn't work that way.
What does he want?
It's fine. I got an hour and like 15 minutes and my food will be here.
But other than that, the reason I was late, I was doing grocery shopping because I'm going to be working all weekend. Fun times. But,
make sure you eat a lot of pineapple.
Oh, no. The grocery closest grocery store had a sale on 10-pound packages of chicken wings, so I'm stocked up.
He doesn't understand.
Yeah.
So
cool.
But and then let's see. Last night I put together a coffee table, and then my sectional for the living room will be coming Monday. So
you're gonna put the sex in sectional?
Probably not. But. That's what the queen size bed's for, dude.
Yeah, because on the queen size bed, you got the comforter.
A queen is like a fucking twin to you, and you want someone in there with you?
Oh. That way they gotta sleep on top, dumbass.
My wife and I recently slept on a queen when we were in fucking Wisconsin. It was fucking terrible.
y'all got a king size bed too?
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I can do it.
We got a fucking old dog that sleeps in our bed, too.
Well, if you have a big old dog like that, I can understand that. And if I had a dog, and when I bought the bed, if I was in a relationship, I probably would want king, but queen was perfectly big enough for me and the cat.
One man bed.
So.
Way to think about the future, Bugs.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Way to have confidence in yourself.
He's definitely he's probably not buying a dog for a while.
All right, well, let's move on into the fucking news.
Where the fuck are the notes?
The notes are in the toilet.
So we've gotten down to the New York Comic Con, whatever Hasbro reveals.
It's all good.
Somebody went ahead and put all the pictures in here that I was too lazy to do.
I wonder who that was.
So let's talk about the shit.
The only thing I'm interested in is the fucking Earth version of the fucking Starscream.
Damn, that looks good.
Well, you know what? It's because, like, it's almost entirely fucking Autobots.
Isn't that a retool of the classics?
Well, some people are... Some
I think
people
it's a retool of the Egypt one, isn't it?
Well, that's the thing. It's like, some people were saying it's a upsized version of the Deluxe Chug, but there, if you look at it in certain spots, it looks like the base figure is the Siege Voyager. It's just it's been remolded and changed in spots. Which is
happy with the Tetrajet theme.
Well, I have all the Tetrajets, and I will gladly buy whatever Seekers they do out of this new Voyager mold.
Sucker.
Well, the thing is the Rainmakers and Red Wing, that's fine as the Tetrajets, because I mean that's the Rainmakers, that's what they were in the G1 show. So really, if I do replace any Seekers from the Seed shelf, it's only going to be 3. But there's no guarantee that we're going to get as many repaints out of this mold as what we got out of the Tetrajet mold.
No, we're going to get more. We're going to do fun. More.
Mm. Yeah, it's funny that you say that, because they've never not done that.
And somehow I'm going to end up fucking buying a 5-pack just to get the goddamn fucking Skywarp out of it.
Probably. but it has been a concern previously when they have done Seekers where they didn't do all 3 of them. I mean, when they did the first MP mold, we only got Starscream and Skywarp. And then they redid the mold, and then we got Thundercracker. So they were different. But and then there's been several other lines where they've only did 1 or 2. I mean, the animated line, they only did 3 of them, and that was what, Starscream, Skywarp, and Sunstorm. So we didn't even get a Thundercracker in that line. So
well,
it's possible.
Faggot, him
it's
and his possible. Dog.
Go ahead, what? Chris.
I just said he was a faggot, him and his little dog. Go on.
But I'm just saying it's a real possibility that we could not get all the Seekers out of this mold, which could be a concern.
No, it's not a possibility. They've learned by now to do them all. I think they've fucking learned over the years that they gotta do that shit.
There's never not been a fucking company that's made a Seeker mold of some kind and then didn't just fucking repaint it over and over and over and over and over.
Except for Hasbro.
But they just did.
Yeah, and notice how they had to release those. The Rainmakers came in a Target exclusive 3-pack. Red Wing was
the
Target.
Give a fuck how they released them. You got them, didn't
just,
you?
I'm just saying, Target might not be willing to extend the branch to take the exclusives on again if they're going to do, like, the Coneheads as a 3-pack. I don't know.
Here's the deal. They got fucking Hasbro Pulse now that's pumping out fucking sellout pre-orders for every fucking thing. So
exactly.
And they've been unreliable with the whole the freaking Dino cassettes with fucking that up. So
certainly, but they're not going to be able to keep up with demand, so obviously they have an outlet to sell whatever the fuck they want to. You know what I mean?
Well, we'll see.
But let's talk about the fucking elephant in the room is MP10 Lite.
MP10 Lite. No.
This motherfucker is cool, bro. This is fucking Optimus Prime.
Yeah, it looks great, man.
Well, I do agree MP10.
Cool. You know, I get... There's a cat on by my feet.
Isn't this the first Chug we've ever gotten that came with a trailer?
No.
Didn't
that last one come with the last leader class one?
The Power Master from Power of the Prime.
Yeah, no, that don't count. That's trash.
No, the other one.
No, the Siege
that.
One doesn't come with a trailer.
I think JL.
So you had the Power of the Primes one that was the Orion Pax and the truck, and then the trailer was the body.
That's what I'm talking about.
And then before that, it was the Combiner Wars Magnus remold in the Power Master Prime. So those are the only two Chug that actually came with trailers. And if you want to count the Fans Project trailer made for the original Chug Prime.
Well, nobody a couple counts. Of movie ones did, too. So I'm showing that out there.
All right, is this the first one that came with a trailer and didn't look fucking stupid?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, all right, good. It looks fire, dude. That arc playset looks fucking great, too, even though it's just a fucking tunnel. Yeah.
Well, it is pretty cool how the tires on the back of the trailer, now I've seen some people pointing out that it looked dumb, but it's like they fold up, so it allows the trailer platform to actually connect to all these other city playsets that they're coming out in the next line, and so it'll connect to Omega, it'll connect to Astro Train, it'll connect to all these weaponizer guys that they're coming out, like Ironworks.
This stuff all looks really good, man. I'm impressed.
Yeah, I wish this shit came out 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think that half the reason for the new MP44 was the fact that they were going to basically use MP10 Qs to build this thing?
No.
Nah, I think it was just Takara's way of continuing the line, because it's going to need a jump start from those core characters with a better version every couple of years to allow
it to like it has better articulation.
In your chug figure that's in your fucking masterpiece and just sit there and be like, oh, I have this like oversized.
Because, I mean, if Masterpiece is going like 10 years from now, I guarantee we'll have another Optimus and another Seeker. So,
I think it looks better than MP10. So there's that.
That looks great. Like, I really don't have another fucking Chug Prime. But, like, it looks really good.
I don't either. It comes with a roller and everything. Or no, maybe it doesn't.
Nah, it's just somebody repainted a Rook.
Oh, fair enough.
Throw that in the trash.
But who knows, they might throw it in there.
I'm not going to get this, but I know all of you guys will.
What?
Yeah, I'll be getting that Optimus.
Man, I don't know. If I get it, I'm going to get rid of my Siege one.
Yeah, that's what I'm... Well, I got to see what they're going to do with Megatron, because the Siege Optimus is going to stay with the Siege Megatron, but if they release a new Megs, then they'll be both going.
And now I know what it feels like to relapse on fucking drugs, because like I don't want to buy none of this shit no more. But then I'm like, oh, I'll just try it out, and I buy it, and I'm like, I feel like shit. I feel like a piece of trash.
I saw an interview with the guy, the Takara designer. He's saying, you know, about the upcoming Megatron. It's going with this line. He's like, we see that America shoot up at children in a school, so we make a Megatron gun. Fuck you.
Are they legit doing that?
No.
Oh, Jesus, I want them to make Christ. Them a gun again.
I hope they do. Fuck
I
it.
I think the classics Nerf gun is the last one we're probably ever going to get.
Yeah, maybe.
I want a Megatron that turns into an AR-15.
Oh.
Like a real one?
Sure, why not? That'd be fire.
Cool. What do we want to talk about next? The grapple? The grapple looks cool.
The grapple looks, I mean, it looks great too. Like, this shit looks really good.
He looks like a downsized MP, and I like the the claw hand that they gave the crane that can plug in on the side.
Yeah.
In storage.
Yeah. They gotta figure out fucking armhole covers, though, man. Cover that hole. God, Jesus Christ, it's not that hard.
No, you just cut a piece of the box out and stuff it in there. That's where you're supposed to hide your crack cocaine, dude. When you go,
why couldn't they put this shit out 10 years ago? You know what I mean. Like,
we would have saved so much fucking money.
If you go back farther than 10 years ago, this shit was good. That's the thing.
And look, they go and put hoist out because they're putting grapple out before they put Trailbreaker out.
Right, and it's very rare that a grapple comes out before an Inferno. It's always usually the other way around.
Yep, they're doing them both this way. Like fuck you, first ones. It's our turn.
That hoist looks fucking G1 as shit, dude.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, it does.
I don't like that robot mode. He looks dumb.
Yeah, but he looked dumb. He looked dumb when he was like fucking...
That's fair.
Like, that's how the G1 toy is. The fucking back of the arms hang down like that. It was stupid as shit. That's how it was.
Plus, keep in mind that these are fucking hand-painted. You can tell these are acrylic paints. It looks like fucking shit that I do. I mean...
Right. So, what are your predictions? Because, like, the Ricochet repaint out of that Mega Jazz was a Hasbro Pulse exclusive. You think they're going to have a Hasbro Pulse exclusive Art Fire out of the Inferno remold?
You know they will. It would be nice to just go to the store and buy that bitch for like $20, though.
It'll be Voyager, so it'll be $30, but...
I tell you what, though, man, I want to fucking play with this
fucking
Zip
Jumper.
Oh, God, it's
$30 now. Thanks, Unicron.
Oh, God, Eric.
I want this Cliff Jumper, too.
Cliff Jumper looks cool. That's about the coolest one.
That's probably one of the best-looking Cliff Jumpers ever made, still.
It's better than any of the MP offerings that have come out.
It's pretty damn close.
I don't know about that, but it looks good.
It's pretty damn good. If it was, like... more like the real fucking car, you might actually be able to put on that shelf. He's a deluxe, too. He's not a legend.
Oh, well, so that'll work great with Bumblebee.
Well, his gun is big, so I'm not sure how tall the deluxe he's going to be. I wish they would have had some of the old, like the Power of the Prime, or which was it? Was it? No, it was Titans Returns that Bumblebee was in. It'd be nice if they brought out the old figures to show how tall he is in comparison to them. Because that's going to be the sticking point for my collection.
He's well, you like don't gonna think they're like $20? Who cares?
You don't think they're going to do a fucking another Bumblebee?
Oh, sure they will.
I'm surprised it's taken them this long and we still haven't seen one yet.
Yeah.
Well, it's like when the Bumblebee came out in Titan Return. I thought we were going to get a Cliff Jumper. Instead, they did Chase from the.
If they don't make the Unicron, they're going to melt the ones they made down and make the yellow plastic into Bumblebee.
I mean, now that they have the engineering for the Cliff Jumper, they have the Bumblebee.
You would think.
I wish that wasn't the case. I wish they'd make a whole nother fucking mold for him. That head sculpt is fucking great. Mm-hmm. That's a good looking figure.
Cool.
Durr.
So what about the Hoist and future Trailbreaker?
I think the Hoist looks great too.
Yep, but I looked
much
at
better than the first attempt that they did, the Generations one.
Yeah, and the back of their legs is completely hollow though.
So is the arms. Like they're starting to do that hollow shit again. That's really a bad thing.
Yep.
Well, in today's day and age, you can always order Shapeways to fill in that. A lot of people have been developing those filler kits for the waffle figures.
Yeah, thanks.
You should fill it with fucking cheese curds.
It'll be all right. But yeah, I'm not going to buy any of this shit.
I'll get a few of them. Probably, I'll definitely get a Skywarp if they come out with him. Probably get the Starscream just to have it. I definitely want that fucking Cliff Jumper. He looks awesome.
Yeah.
And I am curious why they have Astro Train, who is in the current line, showing him off with the coming line.
Because he's not out yet.
Well, yeah, I understand that, but I thought there was supposed to be some other leader that they kept hinting about on TFW that we were supposed to see, and they didn't show it.
Hey, what about that Ironworks, man? That fucking Microsoft.
Yeah, let's talk about that, man. Because I'm
cool
kind of salty about it.
Why? I think it looks great.
Man, I love the Micromaster bases, but I don't feel like it needs to transform into a robot.
Yeah, but I think it doesn't have to. It doesn't have to do anything.
Well, it doesn't have to, but I don't even like the option of it.
No, it's just added playability.
Exactly. So you're trying to say you want to take our rights away, JC?
I don't want to play with it. I want to look at it.
You fucking communist.
It's fine, man. Whatever. Like, I think just change up. Just ruined my fucking best year of my childhood.
Honestly,
is that the one where you weren't in jail?
Mm-hmm.
If somebody just like the panels on top of Ironworks, and then like the bridges that they have coming off of there, if somebody just like knocked those off, I could see those being quite popular for displays and stuff.
I'll be right back.
Oh Lord,
fuck yourself, Eric.
What? Yeah, I think that thing looks cool as shit, and I love the little Micromasters they're doing this time, man. They got the fucking 57 Chevy guy. I don't know their fucking names, and they got a. Did they do the monster truck yet?
Monster truck guy? That'd be pretty flames if they do.
Yeah, I like the monster truck guy was my favorite.
I mean, I'll look at it at the store and just like admire it for a moment and walk away though.
I feel like.
You should grab it and then throw it a couple aisles over and try and hit somebody with it.
I feel like I feel like I need to buy that 10-pack that was a Target exclusive now.
You can still buy it on I actually am looking at it right now on Target's website. You can still buy it, dude.
Because aren't several of the MicroMasters in that 10-pack ones that came with the bases
back in the day? You got a little semi-truck guy. You got a little fucking Ironhide-looking guy. I don't know none of their names. Nobody knows any of their fucking names except for you, because you're a nerd.
I'd never learned all the MicroMaster names, unfortunately.
You got Derp and Tard. Fuckface and Shitpiece.
Those guys are great.
These bitches are, like, fucking great. I need to go get... I'm going to do that this weekend when I'm off. I'm going to drive up to fucking Target and see if I can find it. And come home and stick them in my ass.
Yeah, I see it's still $40 on Target.com. It's like...
That's $4 a piece. That's cheap as fuck, you broke bitch.
I like a deal, though. So if they, like, knock $10 off, I'd order it right now. But...
Well, if you want a deal, go to the dollar store and buy a couple of micro machines and then stick them in the box and return it. That's what somebody...
Micro machines are fucking baller, though, man.
I love my micro machines growing up.
I don't give a fuck, man. Those things are cool as shit. I wish I had a whole bunch of them.
They were cool, and it was funny as shit, because they cost more than Hot Wheels.
Yeah.
But you got, like,
cooler because they were small.
I always liked the military ones. That was my favorite.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Guy would talk all fast.
Yeah. John Machida. Did you know he's gay?
Yeah.
I imagine everybody's gay.
He's just married. Well, yeah, true, but...
Yeah, I didn't know he was gay until he just got married. Showed that picture.
He just got married. He married some dude.
Like, oh!
He's still alive?
Yeah, he's still alive. If you're going to marry a dude, you marry a dude with a fast mouth, right?
Yeah, I wonder if he sucks dick that fast.
Lord, imagine how he can suck a dick.
No, you're the only one trying to think about that.
A tongue action blow might make a motherfucker turn gay for 5 minutes.
For 5 minutes?
You can't see on the other side of the wall, son.
Wait a minute, you can only... You could be gay for only 5 minutes? Then why wouldn't everybody try it? You fucking white
slick. I'm just saying, man, you can't see on the other side of the wall. Just, there's a hole there. You can. Don't make you gay.
Are you talking about a glory hole?
I don't know. JC sounds like he's talking from personal experience.
However you want to do it, man. You know what I mean? If you want to throw, like, a towel over the motherfuckers and you don't see them.
The glory is the glorious of all holes.
You know what I mean?
Paint a chick's face on his ass.
Yeah. So anyway, I want a Titan size countdown. But I don't want it to transform into a robot.
I want it to turn into a robot automatically so you can't fucking not avoid it.
But watch it be like an Omega Supreme repaint.
Oh, that would be cool as shit.
Yeah, it's not a bad idea, but I couldn't handle it.
Man, when I was at RetroCon, this dude had like fucking a couple of them. That was badass.
Yeah, man, I love that fucking toy, but I don't know why I've never bought one.
So how about this wheel jack?
How about that ugly motherfucker?
Yeah, it's way better than the last one. It looks better in pictures. This picture you got here, it doesn't look good. This is that motherfucker that poses all the shit for the photos when it first comes out.
It looks like shit.
It's better than all the other ones.
Hey, Todd, how's your vertigo going? You want to go set these fucking figures up?
I think the original Classics one...
Yeah, but that one's old as shit.
Yeah, well, sometimes new ain't the better, man.
He had such stubby thighs, though.
You got stubby fucking thighs, though.
The last one, man, the fucking combiner with Bill Jack.
That was fucking straight garbage.
I never made it to the shelf, dude. I got home with it. I opened it up. I threw that motherfucker on the pile of Gundam boxes. I was like, fuck this shit.
Yeah, I don't even know what happened to the one I bought.
I threw him right in the box with the shit that I dumped at the toy shop, too. I was like, get out of here.
Fuck yeah, man.
You're a loser.
All right, what do we got left to talk about here? Let's move on to Custom Spotlight. We're not doing that tonight. So fuck y'all.
No, the Custom Spotlight did.
But we are going to move into KO Corner. It looks like we got from Siri Toys, knockoff.
Siri Toys?
Whatever, man. That's what I call Siri Toys. I can't read and shit.
Durr.
I run a deep fat fryer, man. Fuck.
Goddamn Siri toys and shit.
It's fine, but it's a slash. Like, I mean, we're gonna fry that fucking chicken.
Yeah, we're gonna.
But it's a slash. Fry that chicken.
Damn right, boy.
I guess that's all we got for KO Corner. It looks small. Like, what's the point of it if it's so small?
It's slightly bigger than the other one.
Slightly, like an inch?
What? I don't even think it's an inch, dude. Honestly, look, because that's a fucking deluxe prowl right there, and it probably comes up to right around where Prowl's bumper is, the actual one. So, slightly bigger.
Pretty much
slightly
pointless.
Slightly big.
Fair enough.
We're going to fry that chicken.
Well, this... Yep. Damn, damn, damn. Cool. Asshole of the Week. We're going to talk about the Cybertron Cafe and how out of control it got.
Man, yeah, fuck y'all.
That place went fucking stupid this week. So I just want to throw that out there.
All right. I must have missed it. How it happened.
Well, let's see here. Let me fucking pull up some dumb shit.
You can't just tell me from memory. I have a very vague passing interest, so just tell me what it was quick.
The fucking Unicron crap started coming back again. Everybody's freaking out about it again, fighting.
It's going to make them Chuck's going to be $25. You fucking
Everybody's book. Being fucking stupid, and, you know, I just really fucking hate the fandom, and I wish everybody could get together in one spot and we could just bomb the fucking place.
Jesus Christ.
You know what I mean?
No.
Like, fuck, man. It's just annoying. So,
JC, whatever. The fucking Al-Qaeda, the fucking...
Fucking fan. Nerds. I'm not really going to do that, obviously. It's just a fucking... You know, it's like, goddamn. Y'all shut up.
Man, shut the fuck up.
Exactly. Shut up about it already. Goddamn. Stop arguing.
Right?
Fucking right as law, bud.
It also but goes yeah, into Bo-Shat. My...
I tell you, you love Bo-Shat.
Fact
yeah, what do you got?
Selling or trading or buying Transformers.
Yeah, nobody's buying anything, man. What is the point of buy and sell trade groups if nobody's going to spend any fucking money?
What's yeah, money?
Still.
You know what I mean? Is everybody's broke these days trying to pay for this Unicron.
Yeah, boy!
And their MB-44s. And their fans,
MB-44s, dude. And business has been real slow. I hope it comes back for DairyCon because I still got some chug to unload. Can we get some dirt?
Rarely come across like a cool sales what? Post anymore.
We need some dirt.
What?
Yeah, boy.
Whatever it is, I don't know what the fuck it is.
Thanks, buddy.
What's up, man?
All right. Well, I suppose we should just move into. You got anything for a deal, JL?
This cheap ass fucking fake Captain Morgan I bought. It's a pretty good deal.
Oh man, great effort tonight, gentlemen.
No, the deal of the week is that Unicron next week, because like it's gonna be expensive to get, sure, but all the fucking tears and salt, it's gonna be worth it. It's like a goddamn bonus.
All right, well.
And chicken nuggets, you can buy 2 6-pieces for $4 now.
God damn, okay.
That's a pretty good deal.
Don't
and you know what?
I
do have a deal, because like, I stopped on the way home to get some nuggets, because Loretta ain't cooking tonight. And so I'm like, let me get 2 for $6, because there's... I wish we had fucking Popeyes. We ain't got shit for fast food here. And so like, you know, a 10-piece is like $4 and something cents. $4 and some change. But you can get 2 6-pieces for $4. And so I'm like, let me get two 6-pieces. And they're like, okay. So I pull up. It's fucking McDonald's. I ordered 12 chicken nuggets. The motherfucker's like, pull over to the waiting area. So I pulled up into the fucking wait spot. And I sit there for like fucking 5 fucking minutes. And the lady comes out. She's like, you had 2 6-pieces? I'm like, yeah. She's like, hey, I gave you an extra one too because you had to wait. And I'm like, fuck yeah. And they were the hottest fucking crunchiest nuggets you've ever had in your life.
Cool.
And I feel like I'm having a stroke right now.
Great fucking story, man. God damn.
I got fucking 18 nuggets for $4. That's a good deal. That's some savings.
Cool.
And I like to poop.
Everybody likes to poop, man.
You fat fuck.
Hey, buddy. Come on, Peter.
Come on,
yeah, buddy.
Fuck, now I need...
Stupid fucking dog. Cool. All right, we got some TKO girls this week. Let me open the notes back up. The first one is... I don't know who the fuck... I think this is Chris's.
Yeah, it is. You know he's trying that shit.
No, I haven't.
But not yet. Got baloney?
I just got a new lead. My baloney has a first name. And it's called Not Consensual.
Oh, boy.
Now, I also put in the second one, Karen here, who...
Of course you did.
Is, it's a meme. It's got a chick dressed in just regular office clothes there with a name tag that says Eileen. She's got white shit all over her face and clothes and neck and everything. And it says, Karen at this year's staff party. The theme was dress up as a famous song title. So
come on, Eileen.
Come on, Eileen.
Oh,
now,
yeah.
This chick is by no means a looker, but with a sense of humor like that, I can work with it.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. She's at a bar because they got a tip jar behind her.
Mm.
Just the tip.
Fair enough.
Good night, folks.
It looks like a little got in her beer, though.
Yeah, man.
Gross.
I wonder what it is, though. It's probably like fucking donut
like,
icing.
Like a whole like bukkake car wash.
You know what? It was probably her way of fucking being a fucking slut and saying, you know what? Fucking 20 guys I need to fucking jerk off all over my fucking face. And I'm going to this fucking costume party afterwards. Nobody's going to believe it's come.
Gross.
One dude at the end of the night.
That's an idea for DairyCon, man, to get some fun set up. The Bukkake car wash.
Bukkake car wash. Faces only, no cars.
I wonder if Wealthy Son's going to be there again.
That shit was fucking hilarious.
All right, who's next?
All right, I got mine up. I actually fucking put some in because I saw a cool post earlier today and I thought it was cool. So one of them is this chick, a 1940s pinup girl sitting on a Jeep, World War II Jeep. Got her legs crossed. And
you mean the only real Jeep that they ever made? Ever?
Yeah. You know, well, that's debatable. We're not going to have that debate here on the show.
It's a Willys.
It's a Willys, dumb shit. And you can't even say it right. So, anyway, she's sitting on this Jeep, cross-legged, looking pretty as shit for the fucking, for the troops. And then right down below, I got another picture of a girl on a brand new Jeep that looks hot as fuck and some cowboy boots and an American fucking flag shirt.
So, American flag dress, bud.
Fucking great fucking history right there. You know what I mean? And they're like almost doing the same pose. Oh, pretty cool.
Flames. They are pretty fire.
You know what I mean? It's fucking American history, bud.
It's America history.
Yeah, God damn some fucking right. Squats fucking body.
Cool, and then below that, there's just a big butt.
Yeah, it is.
This is obviously fine.
No history there.
The big old fucking juicy booty. One leg's like cocked up to like you know, show the whole circumference of the ass, and the other one's cocked back to show it, like, firm.
Yeah, there's fucking history there. As soon as I see that, I'm like, yeah. What the fuck was I thinking about?
This is a fucking can and a half, bud.
Super it's a fat cheap. Butt.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. It's a frothy pooper.
I want to wear it as a mask. Put my face in it or around it or on it.
Nice fucking cum catcher at the top.
What do you mean? He's like, what do you mean, dirt?
He's like, nah.
Why would I not want to wear this as a mask?
That's the dirty part.
You know what sucks is by the time Chris has got that soundboard down, he's gonna quit.
That'd be fun to fucking play with.
Yeah, it would be bullshit. Yeah, but... Alright. That's cool. I guess we got some listener questions, so we don't have a guest, so we're not gonna do fucking 13 questions tonight, so fuck y'all. Again, Phil Hamilton asked, which TF film was more impactful, TF 86 or Bayverse 07? Let's start with Eric.
Honestly, I think the Bayverse 07 was more impactful on the fandom.
Yeah, it ruined it.
Are we talking about an impact on the fandom, or are we talking about an impact, like, in film and pop culture in general?
I think he meant, like, you know, us individually.
How you know what? I hate to say it. Well, individually, the fucking 86 movie, because that's my favorite fucking movie of all time, probably, at this point. Uh-huh. But, like, if you're going to talk about culture and, you know, all that bullshit, then it was the fucking Bayverse. It changed how people see Transformers.
Yeah, but how much of that was, you know, just laying on top of the foundation that Marvel had started and, you know, people becoming more accepting of superhero and big transforming robots and action out the fucking ass?
Yeah, but that might have been part of what got that going, too.
That's true. The thing is, I think that Transformers 07 would have happened with or without the 87 movie, because the original toy line had the mythos. Movie. Well, whatever.
It's important, Eric. Yeah, I know you weren't born yet, but it's important.
I was born 84, fag. But the point is that the series itself without the movie made its mark on pop culture. So even if the movie wouldn't have happened with the originals, I still think the movieverse would have happened, and it'd still be more impactful on the culture than what that is. Because where do you see anything else really referencing that original movie? Like, a lot of people forget it even existed.
Well, those people are called losers.
And I know a bunch of people who never forgot. Their name's the Cybertronic Spree.
Yeah.
I don't think you can gauge the impact for about 5 more years yet, and then we'll see what collectors emerge from that. Like, if in 20 years or in 10 years from now there's 40-year-old men sitting around having a podcast about the Bave movies while they're surrounded by Michael
Bay toys. They already have that.
I understand that, but these are younger people, and there's not that many of them. But, you know, there's hundreds of us G1 guys that are surrounded by G1 toys right now that are pushing 40.
But do you have the G1 toys because the G1 movie or the G1 show?
Both.
That's what I'm saying.
Both.
Because, yeah, I mean...
And not only... I take that back. It's a combination of the three, really. It was the show was great. The movie was fantastic as a kid, but it was the toys that kept it alive for you all the time, every day, 24 hours a day. You're sitting there playing Transformers when you're fucking 6-7 years old, you know? That shit lasts.
Same little robot from like when we were little kids.
So I think that's more impactful. Like, I don't think I would have even collected if it was just based on the show and the fucking movie. I wouldn't only collect if I hadn't have played with the toys.
Well, and that's what I was getting at, is if you had the toys and you had the show without the movie, I don't think that really changes much, other than you don't really have any of the season 3 characters, but yeah.
I think it changes the way I want my figures to display. I think it changes the way I want them to look, because the movie had a different look to it, and I want my shit to look like that. You know what I mean? I don't want it to look like fucking animation errors and shit. So,
it is, you know, me personally, I think that the Bayverse movie in 07 impacted me a lot, just for the simple fact that it reminded me that Transformers was there. And I started collecting and buying stuff.
I never really forgot.
I mean, yeah, I never really forgot, but it was one of those things that, like, up until then, I didn't have anything anymore. Not a thing from my childhood.
Well, and it also made it okay to, somewhat socially acceptable to be a collector, because suddenly it was mainline. It wasn't just a kid's cartoon. It was something that was in theaters.
Yeah, I could see that too, but...
Nah, we're still fucking nerds, bro. Nerds! I wouldn't go that far, bro.
But if it wasn't for the 07 movie, I would have never started collecting, and I wouldn't be sitting here talking to you guys now.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, I mean, you know what? The truth is that fucking movie, despite how it's aged, it did bring me back into it, too.
Yeah, that's like, what I'm saying. I think that's more impactful on me than...
But, like, I don't know if it said it brought me back, or if that it brought Transformers back, you know? Like, in the mainstream, it was like something you thought about again. Because when did MP10 come out? What year was that? 05?
No, it was later than that.
Well, I had MP01. When did he come out?
MP01 came out in 2003, I believe.
Yeah, because I found that before, but, like, I didn't even know Transformers, like, was a fucking hobby at that point. I just found it in the store and bought it.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
All right, well, I hope that answers that question. Felix asks...
I hope it didn't.
Why is there such a division in collecting? No matter the item collected, there is always two different kinds of collectors. because I'm an asshole.
Yeah, exactly. That's what it boils down to. There are two types of people in this world. There are the people who enjoy being assholes and the people who don't. So, that's why.
And, like, I think assholes have more fun in imagination land because they can just let loose.
Right.
And to me, Facebook is imagination land.
Damn, imagination.
We're jerks.
Yeah, man. It's fine. It's like a playground for grown-up kids.
Man, you know? I find myself doing it less and less.
Yeah, me too, but I still dabble.
Yeah. Can't put it fucking all the way. I basically do three things with my phone when I compulsively have it in my hand. It's either play this fucking miniature golf game, look at Facebook itself, or on Messenger. That's it.
Yeah, sounds right. I don't play any games, though.
I don't know. I use about every app on my fucking phone every fucking day.
There.
Oh, that's fun. Cool. What's the next question? Anybody else want to get on there?
I think it's because being a dick is fun.
Yeah, man. Yeah. That's all that is. Like, I want to fucking show you that my dick is bigger than yours, and, you know, and that's the way it is.
Mine is pretty big.
Yeah, man. It's just fucking a monster. Like, carrying around hurts. Yeah, operation.
That is such a basic human emotion, though, to want to one-up somebody or to fucking show your dominance of it. So, it's a...
I mean, it would be if I wasn't already way
better. And with nerds, it's like fucking nerd knowledge. Yeah. You know what I mean? Or some dumb fucking shit about some dumb shit that don't fucking matter.
He knows more than you.
Yeah, whatever, bro. fucking that shit went on pre-order yesterday. You're fucking dumb. Like, okay, go fucking eat a dick, faggot. So
what?
Cool. Yeah, not you. I mean, well, you can.
No, I'm good.
That's cool.
I'm trying to cut back. Jesus
Christ.
All right. Well, how many fucks do you give when you bury a favorite broken toy?
I've never buried it.
No, Felix. What the fuck's going on, Bo?
I don't know, Felix. That's my boy. He gets high on peyote and shit.
Nice.
Plays with toys.
Nice. Like,
that sounds fire.
Yeah, that's my fucking boy. He's got that fucking like that Native American shit going on. Get some Native American drugs.
He drinking much fire water?
But I think what he means like when you have to dispose of it, and I give zero fucks.
No.
But I've never broken a toy that actually meant something to me. Like
I paid somebody to fucking blow toys up before.
Yeah, like I've never broken anything that I cared about, so I'm sure if I did, I'd be pissed.
I don't know. You broke your home.
How?
I don't know.
Well, I do break shit around here.
Yeah.
I fixed a coffee table tonight, though, like a man.
Broke your family.
He can't undercoat his fucking Jeep, but
he can't undercoat his fucking Jeep. He can make a table out of fucking
I don't want to crawl under nothing, man. Shit.
You just walk in, fucking JC's got a fucking...
You don't even really have to, like, lay down to get under that thing.
JC got a fucking a fucking table made out of a wood pallet and four dildos for legs.
No, I hear you.
One keeps disappearing.
Yeah.
And then, I think it would suck if it was a figure that you liked, like a fan's dolls.
I've never broken anything I really cared about, except for I guess you can't really break it, but when my Electro broke into 15 fucking pieces, that kind of sucked.
Yeah, that's sad.
I glued them back together, though.
Oh, wow.
And then I got one from Eric for like $5.
Oh, yeah, a G2 thing?
Yeah, G2 Electro.
Didn't the one Eric get you was in the package still?
Yeah, it's fucking Schrodinger's Electro. He's simultaneously mint and broken at the same time.
Oh, wow.
I guarantee you if you open that package, that motherfucker will crumble in your hands.
That's pretty baller, though.
Yeah, I'm going to save it until it's the last one on Earth, and I'm going to retire off that motherfucker.
Yeah, from I got it from Matt Trimberger, and from what he said, he found it at a garage sale, like, somebody bought it as a Christmas present for a kid way back in the 90s, and then it got buried in a closet, and then they found it and sold it at the garage sale.
It was probably from DA. He's like, fucking Autobot trash. Fuck you.
A re-gift.
Well, I guess that's it. Anything else anybody want to talk about?
Yeah, yep. I just put a picture of my dick in the DMs. You want to see it?
We got our hotel reservations for DairyCon, so come out and see us.
Yeah, all of y'all, two of y'all.
Doing it real big.
Me and Eric are going to win all the fucking prizes.
Damn right we are.
So,
I love it.
I'll be at TFCon next week or a couple weeks, sucking some dick.
We're going to have all the... I'm going to be there with my real friends. Fuck y'all.
Running around saying,
probably. I got nothing else to fucking do.
Yeah, that's true, man. Sorry, bro. Not this year, but maybe next year.
You don't got that goddamn money for fucking DairyCon and shit, but no, man. Fuck.
Right, DairyCon's a 2-hour fucking drive.
And
it's only a 2-hour flight. Get the fuck on a plane, bitch.
Nah, DairyCon. The last DairyCon was the last time we'll all be together.
Nah.
I don't think that's true at all.
I don't believe that in my heart.
I won't allow that to happen either.
Yeah, that's not gonna happen.
Yeah, fucking DA's gonna buy a gun and fucking kidnap Eric and JC and drive their ass down here.
I've never been down to the East Coast. I need to get out there.
I'm seriously thinking of RetroCon next year if I can get these two delinquents in Iowa to go with.
Yeah, that might be cool. Let's just see where TFCon dice rolls next year. And
probably Chicago.
It's gonna be in Hawaii. Yeah, but that was fun as shit when we had that fucking steakhouse.
Well, we ate that fucking acid, man. That shit was... man, I'm not doing that again.
JC, I got bad news for you, man. You never came down from that. You're still in the fucking asylum. You just imagine everything.
No, we, fuck.
We need to get Felix. Get us some of that peyote.
Yeah.
Up all night frying fucking balls, and the next morning.
I would have got some shrooms. I would have been fine. I would have been fried out fucking the whole day at the convention. God, that was dumb.
That was funny as shit, man.
I can't take anything that's going to make me throw up. I just can't do it.
Shit was fucking awesome.
I was sitting there at the bar with Robert, and, like, I'm all fucked up. You know, like, I'm all fucking stoned and drunk as shit. And he's like, he thought I did acid, too. I'm like, no, man, I'm just fucked up.
How did he even fucking know?
I don't know, man. Well, you were running your mouth and shit when you were high, dude. Y'all were all doing it.
Tyler was running around telling people we were tripping on acid, probably.
Yeah, probably.
He came in your room and told you he was a hot chick.
He's cute. He abandoned us. Fuck Tyler.
He won't love us no more.
He won't come visit me.
He don't love you no more.
It's fine. All right. Well, good night, folks.
Good night, losers.
See you next week.
Let's be quiet.
Penis.
Since some people are too lazy to read, here are the shout-outs. Shout-out to TF and WTF Ever, the greatest Transformers and what-the-fuck-ever Facebook group ever. El No Customs, an international consortium of Transformers customizers and creators. Third-party TF Crashers, Yula Blamo. Hail Hasbro Reviews with Matthew Deluxe Baldwin. Shattercast Uncut. Bobby Skullface Reviews. Legions for the Fountain of Material. The Realm of Collectors. Figabangin. The entire Cool Table Network. The Blackout and Shout Podcast. And of course, girls who make bad decisions with their bodies and the fathers and or uncles that made them that way. And we wouldn't be a show without alcohol, marijuana, and coffee. The lifeblood of this program. If you liked what you heard and want more, like and subscribe. Comment and let us know what you thought. If you're on Facebook and want to join the party and become a fellow drag, we're at TF and WTF Ever. All hate mail can be sent to tkothepodcast@gmail.com. We'll be back next week with some more nonsense.